evening, you're watching The Logical Indian. I'm Navya Singh and I'll be presenting the top 5 news that deserve your attention today. The Ministry of Home Affairs issued a statement today which clarifies that the movement of migrant workers, tourists and students who've been stranded across parts of the country will be permitted based on certain conditions amid the lockdown. The ministry has written to the state governments to ensure a standard protocol is set up and to designate authorities for the movement of such people. This, ladies and gentlemen, comes after several migrant workers were stranded across parts of the country and several students were stranded in different states as the nation went into a lockdown. The Ministry of Home Affairs has also clarified that all these people will be screened at their source and the destination to ensure safety of everyone. A US panel has noted a sharp downward turn in religious freedom in India in 2019, labeling it as a country of particular concern for the first time since 2004. The panel has also advised the State Department to impose targeted sanctions on India and on officials who are behind the violations of religious freedom in the country. Responding to these allegations, India has said that this is not the first time that the panel is putting across its biased opinions against India and that it has reached new levels of misrepresentation. In a shocking report released by the United Nations, it has been pointed out that the lockdown and the current disruptions to the health services will leave as many as 47 million women in lower and middle income countries not have access to modern contraceptives. This will lead to 7 million unintended pregnancies. The report also points at how women who will not have access to family planning or modern contraceptives and will become victims of gender-based violence will skyrocket by millions in the coming few months due to the crisis. The Health Ministry on Tuesday issued a strict directive against the use of plasma therapy on COVID-19 patients, saying that it is still in the experimental stage. The ICMR, which is the Indian Council of Medical Research, is conducting a nationwide study to measure the effectiveness of this treatment. The ICMR also said that plasma therapy is only being used for research and trial purposes and there is no evidence to suggest that it can be used for treatment. Punjab Chief Minister Amrinder Singh today announced that the lockdown in the state has been extended for 2 more weeks till May 17th. However, the state government will provide relaxations for 4 hours every day from 7 a.m. to 11 a.m. for industrial activities. The Chief Minister also said that social distancing should be followed at all times.